Hi friends, how are you? I hope you're having a very nice day and you're having a nice beginning of this week. So this is a spread that I've done for all of you. And I would like to tell you that this spread is about, you know, what is happening with a karmic partner, or when is it ending, or when are they leaving, you know, or more so about the scenario that is going on, you know, in the masculine's sphere, you know, regarding the karmic partner. So we are particularly seeking the dynamics that are happening with them in this spread, and not particularly focusing or controlling the timeline, you know, and we will see what comes out, you know, because this is a live spread that is happening. So this is a live spread that is happening, and also I would like to tell you that these are oracle cards, but they are heavily laden with the negativity also, you know. I wouldn't label them technically as ethnic oracle cards, because like I said, I always use tarot because I want to get the negative messages also. So these were selected by me because these do portray negativity in various forms, also, as well as positivity is important, negativity or negative messages are also important as well. And I would also like to tell you that this deck was donated by Sarah Spencer, one of my very esteemed clients. So, you know, donations can be in any form. It can be in the form of money to PayPal, or it can be in the form of, you know, other items which are necessary for this kind of energy work also. So just letting you know that information, you know, and not in any way asking you for it or something like that. But a very big shout out to Sarah Spencer. So I will begin the spread right away. And again, like I said, this spread is about karmic partners on the masculine side. And what dynamics they're holding in the current energies, you know, if you are first, second, third waiver, it doesn't count, you know. This is a general spread for karmic, so let's begin with it. So friends, see, look at the spread. This is the whole spread. So I will go on now with the spread. Let's start the spread. So the first card, the entry card that we get, is coming apart. Can you just believe it? We are focusing on the karmic partner and the triangle that has been formed, and the first card that we get, the entry card, you know, is coming apart. Now, what is happening is that the breakups have already happened, or they are in the process of happening. And for some of you, what is happening is that the masculine, the divine masculine, look at the look on the face. The divine masculine is realizing that there are a lot of differences between him and the karmic partner. For what he thought once were similarities, or that she was so similar to him and she was the catch, and you know, she was the one who was supposed to be the one, and he perceived her to be the wife, you know. Now you can change the genders accordingly. This can hold true for a divine feminine also, or a divine masculine, you know. Anybody can be in that energy, and also this is LGBT friendly. So the first card that we get, the entry card and the exit cards, are quite important cards, you know, and so is the central card. But we get the coming apart right at the beginning, you know. This is amazing, you know, amazing in a way that, you know, it is not something to hate upon karmic partners, but this is what is going to lead you forward on the twin journey, you know. This is one step which needs to happen, and until this happens, you know, you are in the phase where you are just dealing with karmic partners and you can't do any better, you know. So the breakups have already happened for many of you, or the breakups will be happening in the future. And for some of you right at this moment, what is happening, that he's realizing that what all he thought were similarities are not exactly similarities, you know. Like, there's a lot of difference. Even if he chose somebody from the, let's say, you know, he had that society programming, or he had traditional programming, you know, or this has to be done, this is the chosen path, you know. He's now seeing that even if he selected a partner who was from his same ethnicity, race, country, whatever, you know, leaving the divine feminine, who might have been different, or she might have been different in some mental approach or body type, you know, that he's usually used to, or skin color, all that, he feels that he chose that partner because he thought there were similarities, but now that concept is coming apart. There is a divide in that concept, you know. So what he thought was his and what he thought was a combination or a compliment. You see the man's face here and the woman is sitting on the top of the face, you know. What he thought was an integration between the male and the female and a total, you know, compliment to him, you know. He chose her thinking that she's the compliment to him and not the divine feminine. So that concept is coming apart. And you also see the purple and the pink color. Now these messages, if he's feeling now that there are a lot of differences are coming to him while he's in thought or meditation. This is the crown chakra energy, you know, and the pink is the compassion. So he did a lot of things for her. There was a lot of compassion involved. He spent a lot of money also on her, you know, but overall he was very loyal and faithful to her, you know. He was giving her the kind of love that he wanted to give anybody who he thought was his twin flame or soulmate, you know. He did not realize that she was a karmic soulmate or a karmic partner who is going to teach him very crude lessons, you know, very rude awakenings are going to happen. But he, in all his innocence, gave all this pink energy to her. And now with the purple energy mixing with the pink, you know, the purple color mixing with the pink, it means that his crown chakra is now telling him revelations about this female. And with the revelations, the pink energy is being divided. You see the divide over here? It is a mirror, you know. It is getting divided, you know. So now this is the strength reversed. Now after this event has happened or is going to happen, or he has realized in his mind or crown chakra that there is a divide and you know, she is not meant to be and she is not the one, he has lost a lot of strength, you know. He's feeling very dejected. He's feeling very you know, very sorrowful, very dejected, and like all of his, you see the green color here, but it is in reverse, the card is in reverse, you know. And he's feeling like you know, lot has been lost, lot of green energy, which is meaning that lot of where he put his heart in is lost now, you know. And also you see the blue color here, which is reversed. Many of them are not communicating with the karmic partners now. There has been a breakup, you know, or is going to be happening quite soon, you know. And it is coming across as like non-communication, standstill, and the masculine feels that this green energy, you see the green crown, the green dress, and the green planet, feels like this greenery, what he thought was going to heal and nurture his life, you know, is not there. You know, was a fallacy, reversed card. Then now where he is and what he is feeling out of all this that happened, you know, this is what is happening. This is what he's thinking, you know, because he's thinking and these are the sensations of his body losing strength, you know. Losing strength is particularly in the body, because you see a whole body is being shown here, you know, and, you know, carrying the weight. He was carrying the weight of the planet, you know, the weight of the karmic partner. But now his body is giving up, like there's a lot of weight on his shoulders or hand, and the body has given up. Now this is the body. Now how he is feeling is, the feelings are like, you know, you see this hourglass. He was waiting and waiting and waiting. You see the dark blue color. He was waiting and waiting for him to get some messages from this karmic partner, you know. Literal messages, like text messages, because you see the blue color, and also messages from his third eye, you know, the indigo color, you know. He was waiting to get messages from the third eye. You see there is a moon here, you know. And here what is shown is the owl. He was trying to get wisdom and some kind of messages, and some kind of, you know, messages either from his third eye, which means either from his intuition or from her directly, you know. But all is in vain. You see how this female is standing with her back facing, and she is drooping her neck and her face, you know, and there is an hourglass behind her. Means that, you know, he has been waiting and waiting for things to change, you know, but things are not changing, and he's finally come into this doom and gloom. Now this is, shows you, if you look at the entire card, doom and gloom, you know. When is the time when you go to your terrace and you stand looking down at the earth, you know, in a dejected manner, thinking that, you know, it has been so long that I've been putting effort into this, you know, situation, and when do you do that? When you're totally depressed. When you just don't want to be in the house and you go up to the terrace because you can't go outside, you know. It is probably the night time, or you just don't feel like going far because your body strength has been lost. So that is the time when you go to the corner of the terrace and you just hang in there, you know. This is what is happening. Total defeat, total remorse, total pain, heaviness, depression. Now you see how heavy this color is. This blue color, how heavy it is. And he's also feeling that he was kind